Bit of a wild ride today on crude oil. You see the inventories report. You don't see many gap downs intraday, and so it's interesting when it happens. And took a short trade here, got stopped out on the first trade, and we reversed along. So there's a lot of movement in crude oil, so we have the opportunity to take these trades. Sometimes you can lose on both. Sloppy trading, but that's how day trading crude oil is, and it'd be nice to have winners on both sides. But the short was a loss, a $300 stop loss on this strategy, $700 profit target. And you see the 350 there because we subtract slippage and commission. And you see the results here for today's crude oil, weekly inventories, sloppy trading. And on the other strategy for crude oil today, SR countertrend crude oil, nice trade here. This gap down was a big advantage in the SR countertrend crude. This has an $800 profit target, but we exit also at within one tick of the previous day's lows. And so if you say, well, why did it get out there and not its $800 profit target, it's because it also has a rule where it exits within one tick of the previous day's low, which is a good thing because it would have reversed and would have been a break-even stop, and then the second trade would have been a loss. So basically, plus $60 on this, which is pretty much scratch break-even, $110 before slippage and commission and $60 after slippage and commission is how we calculate this on the SR countertrend crude oil trade. And gap fill reverse, or gap fill fade. This strategy did not take a trade today, but it came close. We had a gap up, came within a few ticks of getting into a crude oil reversal, gap fill and reverse trade, which is disappointing because that would have helped out to increase the profits even more. But overall, you know, net profitable between these two strategies, not a lot of profit, but it was net profitable on such a crazy day. You know, it's a lot of times when you have this whipsawing action, it's easy to lose, but we were able to be profitable on that, on those trades. And those are the only trades today. They mentioned that there's a lot of volatility in the markets. And, you know, there is, but it's just narrow-ranging volatility. It's just, it won't sell off and it won't go up. And so we're stuck in this low VIX environment right now, just waiting for breakout. And we have a holiday next Monday as well. So the first week of the year we had a four-day week, and then next week we have a four-day week. But then we have the inauguration after that. And so January could turn out to be a slow month, or maybe towards the end of the month we'll pick up some, but as opposed to last year where January was really, really volatile. So anticipation of volatility still exists as we look at Dow 20K, the presidential inauguration, raising interest rates, and other news events as they hit concerning a new regime in Washington. So these are the trades. You see very, very few trades today, only in crude oil. So that's the update on all the portfolios. Let me know if you have any questions.